The soggy summer is about to take a wild turn. Officials warning of serious damage as an ex-tropical cyclone barrels towards the North Island. The storm comes as holiday hotspots are already clearing up from days of heavy rain. We have reporters in two of the regions likely to be worst hit. And we begin with Sam Kelway reporting from the Coromandel.
A busy day at the Hikawai petrol station, campers heading out of Whitianga as ex-tropical cyclone Hale looms over the horizon.
People are packing up and looking pretty agitated and wandering around, like there's camper vans, trailers here with bikes on, sort of heading out.
Last week, flooding closed State Highway 25 in four places, but this storm is a different beast.
This week it's a cyclone. We know that we're going to get winds of in excess of 120 k's an hour. We know we're going to get 200 odd millimetres of rain, and we know that we're going to have storm surges on the eastern seaboard.
The heavy rain last week in places like Coromandel and Gisborne, that's left them saturated. The rivers are swollen. So we're looking at further flooding, possible slips, possible road closures and power outages.
While many have left already, some are preparing to ride it out. This family making the most of the ice cream weather today.
I'm actually hoping that the storm might not eventuate to quite what everyone says, but maybe I'm naive. Maybe I'm hopeful.
This couple are due to be married next week. They're hoping the weather comes to the party in time.
We'll just hunker down and hope for the best, really.
Bungees, tarps and tape in hot demand at the local hardware store, but the weather's been a blow for businesses.
We're all expecting to have a really nice, good summer this year, because COVID was not good for some businesses last year. And two storms in a row, not normal for this time of the year, so we're suffering.
The local mayor says he's ready to support local businesses, and the priority for the next few days will be keeping the region moving.
The hills and the catchment areas are still pretty sodden, and our road crews are pretty experienced, but they are still dealing with some dropouts on the 309 road and some slips.
For now though, locals staying positive.
Taking the opportunity to work indoors while the weather's rubbish.
Oh, I just spend a couple of days sort of sitting inside reading a book, I suppose, and then hopefully it clears up to get a bit of fishing done later in the week.
Summer plans put on hold yet again.
And Sam joins us live now from Whitianga, where the storm is predicted to bite. Kia ora, Sam. What are the authorities saying?
Well, Wendy, in the last hour or so, the wind and the rain has certainly picked up. At times, the rain driving in horizontally. Over the next 24 hours, we can expect 230 millimetres of rain and wind gusts up to 110 kilometres per hour. Authorities are warning that the worst is yet to come. This storm is going to hit tonight. It'll go through Tuesday and then hopefully pass by Wednesday. As you saw in that story, though, residents and holiday makers who haven't left are staying put. They're told to stay put for the next 24 hours. Make sure anything is secured tightly, making sure tramps, anything like that that could become a risk, is secured nice and firmly. In fact, there are a few people just over my shoulder who are actually in the water swimming. Authorities are warning that's not such a wise idea. But at the moment, we're just waiting for the storm to hit. It is starting to pick up. Earlier this morning, in fact, it was sunny as we made our way from Thames to Whitianga, where we are now. This is one of the regions, Whitianga, that's going to be hit really hard. This is Buffalo Beach, and Brophy's Beach will also be inundated. They're worried about that high tide mark, saying that storm surges could be 30 centimetres higher. So for now, it's time to get inside, stay dry, and wait the next 24 hours out.
Yes, it is. Ngamahi. Thanks to Sam Kelway in Whitianga. Thanks for keeping an eye on that for us. Right, let's head to Gisborne, where reporter Henry McMullen is standing by. Kia ora, Henry. What is causing the most concerns there in Gisborne?
Yeah, kia ora, that's right. I'm here in Gisborne, but it's been very much the calm before the storm here today. But businesses have been out sandbagging once again following Saturday's downpour, which left many of them flooded. But the warnings are still for right across the east coast here. Civil Defence Tairawhiti are urging locals to have grab bags ready and be prepared to evacuate if need be. Now, they've also been out door knocking on campsites, as there's still a lot of holiday makers within the region who don't quite know the roads and how bad the weather can be out here. The likes of Tukumaru Bay last year in March, the bridge completely washed out, and there's forecasts that they're worried that we could have similar scenes along the east coast there. Civil Defence Tairawhiti said today that it doesn't take a tropical cyclone to wash out the already fragile roads right across the east coast here.
All right, thanks for the update. Henry McMullen in Gisborne. And for the very latest on how the cyclone is tracking, let's go to One News weatherman Dan Corbett. Dan, how's it looking?
Well, it's one of these messy ones because it's something we have to keep an eye on. Even though it is no longer a tropical cyclone, it's lost some of its oomph. That it was only literally 12 hours. This massive cloud there, that is the actual low of the ex-tropical cyclone. You say, well, yeah, what's the difference? It may not come in as a big eyewall, but it's going to be a big zone of a wind field. There it is. It gets some oomph, some energy into it through the course of tonight and tomorrow. Follow the area blue, piles into Auckland, Coromandel tonight, and that zone of red, strong, damaging winds, piling right in, right there, and gets down to Gisborne through the afternoon. We're talking 200 millimetres of rain, strong, damaging winds, 6-metre seas, a bit of everything thrown in, some detail. I'll give you more of that coming up a little bit later on.